Hey guys, well, we just started hiking in New Hampshire. This is just out of Hanover. This is what the trail's looking like, and we're only at 960 feet in elevation. But we are about 2-3 days away from being to mount the first big mountain in the Whites, Mount Mousalaki, if that's how it's pronounced. I could be wrong on that. Hey guys, well, we just came out of the forest here and we ran into this pond. Pretty cool. We're at, I'm showing about 840 feet. What are you showing?
850.
Okay, so 840 to 850 feet in elevation. Pretty cool to be in just thick fir tree forest and then spit right out to these little swampy ponds. The only downside is water because we don't really have many good water sources. I haven't been filtering my water for about 3 months now, so I don't drink from ponds at all. So we hit some streams in about 4.5 miles, but it's kind of low elevation, so we'll have to see what they look like. Anyways, we're back into the forest. I'll be back when the surroundings change again. Here we are, and just came out of the forest here. We're at almost 1,100 feet. It's a spectacular day today. The high was 77. There's no breeze, but just the temperature is perfect, 77 degrees. It's probably only 74, maybe right now. And we're about to go up 1,100 more feet, up to 2,200. So we'll see what that's like up there. New Hampshire has been wonderful so far. Other than we kind of ran into a pretty big bubble at Hanover because it's the last official trail town, so a lot of people take breaks. So, oh man, it's pretty. Hey guys, Redbeard Chair here. We are down at the bottom. We're about to head up to Holt's Ledge, which is at about 1,900 feet. As you can see, it's real pretty this morning. It's about 8:30. Is it 8:30? Somewhere around there. So we're kind of walking through this little pond. We haven't seen anybody yet this morning, but we're about to go straight up, and it's gonna be pretty steep from what the AWOL book says. Hey guys, well, we just made it up here to Holt's Ledge, and it's pretty spectacular. I don't know how many more views we're gonna have down here, but we're gonna walk on around, and I see a fire tower up there on the mountain, and I assume that that's where we're going today because we're gonna be hitting a fire tower. You can see New Hampshire is, we're back in the wilderness again. There's really not much out here. It's really quiet. Okay, well, we're gonna keep walking. Hey guys, Redbeard and Chair here. We're walking up, climbing up to Mount Cube, elevation 2,900 feet, and we're right now at 2,100. It's looking kind of much more overcast today. The high is only supposed to be in the 60s, about 64 down in the town, so maybe a degree cooler up here. So hopefully we won't get wet. There's about a 60% chance of rain today. Hey guys, we're about to climb up this mountain here. It's getting steeper and steeper. You can see that's where the trail came from. There's no longer many switchbacks as you begin to approach the Whites. It's just pretty much climbs. It's nice, you can knock off a lot of elevation real quickly. Hey guys, well, we're still climbing up Mount Cube, and it's been very rocky. This is the rockiest of our climbs so far as we've approached approaching the whites. See chair down there. Sometimes it's tough enough just trying to find the trail. Here we go. And we still got about 400 feet left to climb before we get to the top. Well, here we are at the top of, what is this? Mount Cube South Summit, 2,900 feet. We've got a lot of rain coming all around us. So, but I think we're gonna be lucky. Redbeard here. Well, I'm at the bottom of Mount Musilaki. This is our first mountain in the whites we're about to climb. As you can see, we've only got 3.9 miles to get to the top of Mount Musilaki, and that is a total elevation gain. We're at 1,500 feet right now. The summit's at 4,800 feet, so we've got, what is that, 3,300 feet of climbing to do. Yeah, it's gonna be a lot of fun. 3,300 feet and about 3.9 miles, so we'll see how that is. I'm imagining it's going to be a pretty tough climb. However, the descent looks much steeper. So, about to find out what it feels like to climb 3,500 feet in 3.9 miles. I'm looking forward to it. We got a hotel waiting for us on the other side of the mountain this evening. So, we hiked about 3.5 miles to get here, 4 miles. So, just got this last 8.4 up and over, and we're done
here, and we're at 3,400 feet, and it's been a pretty straight up climb. It hasn't been too bad. It's been really steep, but not too rocky until now. It's starting to pick up, get a little rockier, and that's hard because everything is definitely really wet right now. I've been told that tree line is around 4,000 feet. So, being at 3,500, we're getting close to that. So we'll see if that's about accurate. It's not currently raining, so that's nice. So as you can see, the trail just kind of continues to climb.
We are at 4,000 feet. 4,000 feet up in New Hampshire. As you can tell, there's still trees. The trail has, for the last, I don't know, mile, half mile, has been nearly vertical. We're in the clouds, so not much of a view as of right now. Here come some people. Oh no, catching people. Okay, I'll be back when I get past these people. We're just walking on a ridge right now. About 20 feet wide, and then just drop-offs. I've heard from some southbounders I just walked past as I was coming up here. Gosh, I'm so sorry, I've already forgotten your names, but they told me that Mount Musilaki was pretty cool on top because it was like a meadow, grassy meadow. So yeah, we were told that we could camp up here, but it just didn't work out. They said it was extremely windy up here, so I'm probably about to put on my some of my winter clothes and my rain jacket. Well, we are truly in the clouds now. I imagine how great the views would be if it weren't for the clouds, but the great news is that after tomorrow, we have 4 days in a row of just beautiful 80 degrees in the, down in town with no clouds, complete sunshine. So it's gonna be, I think we're gonna have some spectacular weather to start off the whites. Still at 4,460 feet. So still a little bit to go to the top. I'll be back.
Hey guys, well we are almost to the top of Musilaki. We got about 300 feet left. 300 vertical feet left, that is. As you can tell, the temperature has changed pretty dramatically. Woo! Yeah. 360? Not much to look at right now, unfortunately, but I don't mind it. We're gonna have some clear days coming up. You getting cold over there yet, Chair? Chair's other trail name, unofficial, was gonna be Off Trail. But chair stuck, a little better. Okay, we'll be back at the tip top. Okay, well we're getting close to the top here.
Only 300 feet now.
We're not really sure how close, but it looks like we're at the top. Kind of leaving the trees behind us now. See what it looks like. This is what the trail looks like coming down. It is extremely wet. That's what I just came down. It's extremely wet. I've already slipped in probably about three times.
So we're at 3,300 feet. Still have to drop down to 1,800. So at about 1,500 feet left to go. Anyways, it's too dangerous for me to film here. I'm gonna keep going. Still coming down Moosawaki. We've been following this little river for a while now. Straight on down. Beautiful. Hey guys, Redbeard and Cherry here, where we are about to climb this direction up to South Kinsman Mountain. It's 4,358 feet. We're at 2,400, about 2,410 feet actually, right here. And it's a beautiful river. It just flows right down through the mountains here at 2,400 feet. So we're gonna climb up to 4,300 feet in exactly 2.5 miles. So it'll be a nice climb. And then we'll be hitting our first hut. So I'll be back when we get up there. Hey guys, we are climbing up South Kinsman Mountain. We are at 3,200 feet. This is what it's looking like. It is, we've been coming up vertical here. I'm gonna try to hike up some of this without my trekking poles. So we'll see if the rocks are dry enough. We are carrying, well, I'm carrying 2 liters of water. Chair's carrying, how many liters are you carrying? 4?
Water, yeah.
So we can camp up on top of here. It's 4,300 feet and it looks to be flat near the top, and it shouldn't be above tree line. So we had to do about 2,000 feet in 2.5 miles. So we're carrying a little bit heavier packs right now. Yeah, the whites are definitely like this at all times. So I see why your mileage goes from like 17 to 20 to like 12 to 14 a day. But it is beautiful. It's just a lot harder. But it is beautiful up here. It really is. We were following a brook for a while. It was just a cascading waterfall. Definitely takes a lot more out of your legs, I'm noticing. Cardio rise, definitely not too bad hiking through here, just is slower. But as you can tell, it's just so pretty that it's actually a lot of fun. Go just a little bit further, see if it changes at all. I know we're gonna hit a pond up here. We're at 3,300 feet, 3,375. Oh yeah, look at this. You gotta be careful with these boards, sometimes they sink and you get soaked. Look at this. This is why it's different up here. You're hiking up these huge cliffs and then you get to this. Oh my gosh. We're going up there. How cool is this? Man. Man. So beautiful. Wow. Well, we're gonna keep going. Back later. So this is the trail climbing up to South Kinsman Mountain, and this is just kind of what it looks like as far as steepness. Don't want to fall now. Yeah, we're still going up here, just past where he filmed me. Just trying to give you guys a general idea just to how steep the trails are through the Whites. And it's not just like this for a little section. It's like this the whole time you're going up. I mean, you really gotta climb on these. We're at 3,600 feet, so we still got a little bit under 700 more vertical feet to get to the top. Just keeps going right on up. Hey guys, well, we're at 3,990, and we're going up there, 4,300 feet. We're getting close. See if you guys can see ski resort off in the distance. Yeah. So Kinsman Mountain, South Kinsman. Let's get on up there and see what it's like. Well guys, if you're afraid of heights, I don't recommend climbing the Whites. This is the trail up to South Kinsman Mountain, right up there. This is only a 4,300 foot mountain. But as you can tell, it's pretty vertical. That's Musalaki over there. Yeah, it's beautiful. And we're getting close to the top. Well, we're getting close to the very top of South Kinsman Mountain. We're at 4,285 right now, and it's 4,358. Do you know if that's Lafayette over there?
Across the way?
Yeah.
Yeah, Lincoln, yeah. Lafayette.
Wow, that's sick.
Is that where you headed?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Awesome. Eventually. Gonna camp up here somewhere tonight.
Been walking the whole way with the camera rolling? Or?
Not the whole way.
Yeah.
But the top at least.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. Yeah, whenever I get to the real pretty parts, you know?
Yeah.
Hey guys, well, we decided to camp up here on top of South Kinsman Mountain, 4,300 feet. We've got a 360 degree view. That's Mount Lafayette over there. Our tent's perfect pitch. Kind of tucked down there if it gets windy. Chair looks like he's got a good pitch too. Mount Musalaki over there. I don't know how well you can make it out with the bright sun. So yeah, we've only got a 20% chance of rain tonight, so not too bad. And it's just rain. We've camped on a bunch of balds, so I think that we'll be pretty prepared for the wind. But it's gonna be a good test of the Z-Pax duplex tent that I've got. We'll see how it holds up, because I'm sure it's gonna get windy up here. And then tomorrow it's a 0% chance of rain. It's supposed to be 83, so I think we're probably doing this at a perfect time. Tomorrow night we're gonna be staying up on top of Mount Lafayette. We're gonna go to the tip top and then try to find a camp spot to stealth somewhere down there. So anyways guys, I'm sure I'll be back later as the sun starts to go down and we watch the sunset
guys,
tonight.
Well, we're still up here on top of South Kinsman Mountain. We've decided to do a little exploring from our camp spot.
There's Chair, and that's kind of the peak right there, and this is where I'm standing. This is looking south. And there's Mount Musilaki right there, or Musilak. I think I've been pronouncing that incorrectly. Yeah, this is just, wow. Wow.
I need to get your picture.
Yeah, and we can see, if you can see just over top of that hill right here, there's a pond, and that's where we were earlier in the video, looking up here. About to go watch the sunset from right over here. Take you guys over there real quick, but this is just beautiful. We've got pretty clear skies. It's a little hazy, but I'm sure it'll look great as soon as the sun starts to go down. I don't think I've ever been able to look that far down, you know.
It's a long way.
Still showing a little bit.
Let's go.
Gone. Wow. That was pretty amazing, I have to say.
Look how bright the sky's getting right now.
Yeah, it's gonna change. It's gonna change even more. Well, here we're at our first hut in the White, Lonesome Lake Hut. These are kind of like little huts you pay $100-something to stay at, and you can eat dinner and breakfast, family style, and sleep in the room. So, pretty cool. And I think they might have some snacks. It smells really good out here. Okay, we're gonna check it out. Yeah. This is our first hut. What is this hut called again? Lake?
Lonesome Lake.
Lonesome Lake. This is cool.
I asked Sarah what it meant.
This is sweet.
Yeah, no, I wouldn't barely ask.
The views you have out of here, of the lake down there. Wow. How do you like this?
This is nice.
If I
had a
canyon, I would totally use my car. But
yeah, and there's Mount Lafayette. That's where we're about to climb up to. We still have to go down another 1,400 feet before we actually start climbing that. So. Okay. Well, this is the lake that the Lonesome Lake Hut sits on. It's literally just about a few hundred feet back up that trail there. Just absolutely beautiful here. Wow, look at that like rock up there, halfway up. It looks like you could, it's an overhang.
That's the one that was shining earlier, I thought was the hut.
Yeah. Hey guys, well we're approaching the top of a mountain called Little Haystack, I think is what it's called. It's at 4,800 feet. Chair and I accidentally made a mistake at that last hut that I was just filming at. There were a ton of trails, and the AT goes by a different name through these Whites. And we took a wrong trail all the way down to the bottom. Luckily there was another trail that we were able to hit, so it really didn't, we didn't miss anything. So. It's a pretty spectacular view.
Doing?
Hey, how's it going?
Good. Walk through.
Thank you.
Enjoy.
Thanks, you too. Distance. is one we camped on top of last night. And then the biggest one out in that distance we were on the day before that. Over here behind me, I don't know if you can make it out, is Greenleaf Hut. It's right on the edge there. It's a mile off the AT. So yeah, as you can see, we are at the top. Yeah, and if you look behind me, that little lake back there, that's where the hut was that I just filmed. Hello.
All right. You walking the whole trail that way?
Most of it. Wow.
It was great.
Yeah. Did you?
Yeah.
I love this thing. Wow.
I love mine too, but mine it before I left my trip and didn't have time to order another one.
Oh no.
Well.
So this is the next 2 miles of above tree line, huh?
Yeah.
Can see where the trail's gonna go. This is our first exposed above tree line ridge walking for 2.5 miles, and we're gonna go up to the top. I think that's Lincoln right there. We're at 4,800 feet. Lincoln is at 5,089 feet, and then Lafayette is at 5,291. Well, here we are walking on the ridge line, our first above tree ridge line. It's gonna be like this for almost 3 miles, and it's pretty spectacular. If you look to your left, you got that. Look to your right, all the way around. Yeah, I've definitely never done any type of climbing on mountains quite like this. Above tree line. I think this might be my first time to really be above tree line besides just snow skiing in the Rockies, so this is pretty cool. Well, we're still climbing up to, I think this is actually the Mount Lincoln. Trail we just came from. Well, this is the last shot up, so I figured I'd film for a little bit, especially with the view looking like it does behind me. See what it looks like. I'm going. Whew. Yeah, it's pretty amazing. Yeah, a little bit of a drop off, huh? Okay, let's keep going. We're almost to the top. Just gotta make nice, firm steps. Make sure you have good grip. It's important. Oh my God. I think this is Mount Lincoln. I was wrong. We still got more climb to do. I'll let you guys see. So I was wrong. Definitely thought we were on Lafayette, but as you can see behind me, that's Lafayette. So got another climb. So we might break up here. You can see the trail leading back down there. So anyways, guys, this is just breathtaking up here in the clouds off in the distance. I don't know if you can make it out to Mount Washington. So, well, here we are, the last few steps to the top of Mount Lafayette. We just came from over there. Hi. Yeah, you can see the hut down there. That's where we're going to be going to. I thought they said there was a good view up here.
Yeah, I don't know what they're talking about.
Man.
My favorite part is just how quiet.
I know, it's amazing. Hey guys, well, we decided to walk down from Mount Lafayette down to our first lodge that we're gonna stay in, Greenleaf Lodge. We know we're gonna stay there because there's not that many people that come down here. So it's right over there. So it's pretty cool. We do have to walk down 1,000 feet to get to it. Sucks. Hey guys, well, we are climbing down off of, I think this was Garfield, Mount Garfield. The view kind of looked the same as everything else. I think I filmed up there. So anyways, we were just walking down the trail here, and we had just filled up here at this beautiful little stream, and now it is one and the same trail and creek. We're trying to find a camp spot right now, so maybe if we're lucky, this will lead us right to a camp spot so we have water. But we're packing a lot. Well, I'm packing 2 liters. Chair down there is packing 4 liters. So his pack is pretty heavy. It's a little wet, so I'm gonna be careful here. But once again, just this is the whites. Every second you're hiking almost, you're doing stuff like this. I mean, it's even in the areas that look flat or don't look like they're much of a climb, maybe a few hundred feet. This is only a 400 foot climb or descent, but it looks really, really bad. And you can see straight up there, that's where we're going. Yeah, so right goes down, and then it goes up to that first ledge, second ledge before the big up. Right below the second ledge is, you can see, is a hut. I don't know if you can make it out. And then it goes straight from that hut straight up to the tallest point up there, and that is some mountain south, Tinsman Mountain or something like that. Hey guys, well, we just got down off of Mount Garfield. And we just found this awesome little camp spot right here, tucked in all these fir trees. I think they're fir trees. Really, really cool. Just enough room for two. And we have a spring over here, or a little brook. I'll show you guys that real quick. Ha ha.
Oh, don't eat that.
Oh my god, dude, he took the whole thing.
Yeah, your friend's gonna be gone a while. She got the entire piece. He almost came down.
Yeah.
Look, she's coming back.
Is she really?
Dude, look at this little bitty one up there. What is that bird?
I don't know.
Did you get that on film?
Yeah.
Did you get her?
Look, she's coming.
Here you go. She doesn't like you to look at her. Did I drop it? Here. Here you go.
Redbeard here while I'm making my ascent up Mount Washington. I'm only about 2 miles in, and I've gone up a total of 2,000 feet so far. And I'm at a little bit above Webster Cliffs, but I think these might still be considered Webster Cliffs. Came from that direction over there. Getting real windy already. And I still have 3,000 feet till I reach the top of Mount Washington. Well, we're still climbing up the mountain here, up to Mount Washington. It's getting steeper and requires much more technical climbing up here. You don't want to lose your footing, that's for sure. The wind is really strong. Hey guys, well, we are still climbing up to Mount Washington and we're pretty much just above Webster Cliffs, and the trail gets extremely steep here. I'm gonna go ahead and scale up this, hopefully not fall. Thank you. Hey guys, Redbeard here. Well, we just left out of about 20-30 minutes ago out of Mispah Hut, which is the last hut before Lake of the Clouds. It's about 5 miles to Lake of the Clouds hut, and it's about 4, and we decided to just go ahead and push on to Lake of the Clouds, which is definitely the most popular hut, but it's really high up. I think it's only about 1,000 feet below Washington, maybe a little bit more above tree line. So we just wanted to go ahead and get there so we have an easier day tomorrow. We're trying to get to town by Saturday. It's Thursday now, so I think you guys are about to have a view here. So it's definitely been, you can almost see, well, you can see here that we're going to be going up there, and you can't even see Mount Washington right now, but we still got about 3.5, probably more miles left to finish our day off, so it'll be 17 miles today from White. Up and up Mount Washington almost. Looks like we might be getting to a little high point here, so I'll stay on just a little bit longer. Guys, well, getting closer and closer to Lake of the Clouds hut. I assume I'm probably still maybe another mile away, but as you can tell, I'm slowly getting in the clouds here. I'm about to really be in the clouds and not really see anything. So I at least wanted to film one more time so you guys can see this. Well, it's a big moment. I'm just arriving here at Lake of the Clouds hut. Here at Lake of the Clouds hut. A bunch of gross through hikers here.
Hello.
And there's a big crowd of people.
That's how the other half looks.
We're over here at the servants' table, so. Anyways, we're gonna get some food later on, so that'll be great. And we're warm now. Anyways, we'll be back later. Starting the final approach up to Mount Washington. It's about 7:45 in the morning. It's a lot better conditions tonight, or this morning, than it was last night, so that's good. It's still in the clouds, so it kind of stinks, but we'll see. Maybe we'll get lucky. I doubt it, but and it'll open up. But there's a restaurant, kind of like gift shop on top. So they open at 8, so we should be getting there at perfect time for that. Well, as you guys can see, it is starting to open up. Haven't gone but maybe 100 feet higher since I last filmed, but the clouds are breaking away. We're still in the clouds, we're just kind of getting above them right now. So this is really, really neat. We'll see. I still don't think we'll probably get much of a view, but we'll see. So we got, oh, okay. So we've only got 0.6 miles left. So we've already done, I can't do math right now, 0.9 miles. So not too bad. The rocks are slippery, and it's just all rocks, but it's not that steep yet. Hey guys, well, we're getting close to the top of Mount Washington. I don't know if you can make it out up there behind me, but we are above the clouds now. We've even got some views out there. And pretty soon we might have views everywhere. And the wind has really died down. I'd say it's just a slight 5 mile an hour breeze right now. It's gotta be pretty rare for being on top of Washington. Not too much further now, maybe just 200 feet or so, vertical feet. Maybe the most spectacular part of my journey so far. Yeah, last night had a radio playing in the hut, Lake of the Clouds hut, and multiple people had to be rescued off the mountain last night. And it's August, it was August 28th yesterday. So this place is definitely extremely dangerous. There were two guys that left the hut last night around 8:30 to hike all the way back down to the bottom. And I mean, it was gale force winds outside. The building was shaking and you couldn't see 5 feet in front of you. So hopefully those guys made it down okay. Okay, well, as you can see, I'm almost there. I'm gonna put this up and I'll be back at the top. Under the base of the clouds. Well, that's pretty much it from the top of Washington. 6,200 something feet. Hey guys, well when you walk into the top of Mount Washington, they've got this visitor center and restaurant up here. So you can get out of the cold. We're gonna wait, they're gonna start cooking food at 9 o'clock. We got our table picked out here. And you can see where we're going next. So we're gonna be going along that ridge line over those mountains there. I can't remember which mountains. I think they're Madison, Jefferson, and something else. So anyways, pretty cool up here. It smells good. Well, we're about to be in Maine, and this is what the trail looks like through the Mahoosics, the mountain range, right after the Whites. And it is just a lot of climbing and slick rocks. We got rain before we got here, so it was it made it even worse. But we just came from up there. So right down here, close to the bottom, somewhere is the border to Maine. And you can tell that we're pretty much in Maine. It's a pretty thick wilderness now. No cell phone reception, so it's pretty cool. We like it out here. We had to hike a long time last night before we were able to find a camp spot. It was pitch black. Above 3,000 feet, there was just, it was a thicket of trees. So anyways, we're gonna keep hiking. Well, we're getting close to Maine, and this is what the trail is looking like through here at the end of New Hampshire. It's very rocky and very slick. Ooh. Wow, look at that cave right there. Is that actually, can you go in that cave? Back there? Almost looks like, way? Yeah.
No, that's just a rock face.
Wow. Wow, you can definitely go in right there. Look how huge that opening it is.
You can go in?
Man, look at that.
Yeah. That's probably where I'd hide some gold.
Wow. Hey guys, well we just got to the state line, our last state line sign for New Hampshire, Maine. Only 281 miles left to Katahdin. So we are pretty excited. It's already real pretty around here. And you can tell that it's gonna be a great section of the trail. So. Anyways, we're gonna keep moving. We're gonna do a shorter day today, but just take this in for now.